values here are 90%, 95%, 80%, 70%, and 85%. So the maximum possible overlap, x represents the maximum possible percentage of students who may have opted for at least one in all five. The maximum can be the smallest of these values. So we can assume that this 70 happens to be common to the other values, 80, 85. Well, the other values, there may be some overlap, some not, something like this. This can be my 90. But I can assume that 70 is common to all the values, and therefore the maximum possible answer can be 70. Of course, we cannot say that 70% students opted for strategy and 75% opted for all five. That's practically not possible. Mathematically also not possible. So more than 70 is not possible, but 70 is possible. So the highest possible value, 70. That's the answer to the first column. The second column, we need to find out the minimum possible overlap. So let's find the total. This turns out to be 420. See, the total is 420. Let's assume that there are 100 students each, and these are the absolute number of students opting for each of these electives. So if there are 100 students, I am saying that, okay, I want to minimize the possibility of all five electives. So what is the maximum number that can be reached without using five electives? So if I assume that every student opted for exactly four electives, then the maximum possible headcount is 400. The 400 is the maximum value that can be reached without using the case of any student opting for 5 electives. But still, this 400 is 20 shy of 420, the sum of these values. That means that 420 minus 400, 20. At least 20 students have to opt for all of the 5 electives. And therefore, for the second column, the answer is 20%. That's the minimum overlap for reaching a value of 420 from 100 students. Thank you.